the synthesis of vitamin B6. There are two synthesis of vitamin B6. First is by using ethoxyacetate and cyanoacetamide. Ethoxyacetate and cyanoacetamide. These two can be used to synthesize pyridoxine or vitamin B6. The structure of pyridoxine, if you remember it, it is containing a pyridine, where we have a CH2OH here. Then we have a CH2OH, OH, and CH3. So this is the structure for pyridoxine. This is what we want to synthesize. So first, what we will do is we will synthesize the pyridine ring, and hopefully with the functional groups in proper positions. So first we will start with ethoxyacetate and cyanoacetamide. Ethoxyacetate, it is an acetate, so CH3, this is an acetate group. Acetate means here another acetyl group is there, and it is a ethoxy. So now here we will have a CH2OC2H5. So it will now be a ethoxyacetate. With cyanoacetamide. Acetamide, we know that it is a CH2CONH2. This is an acetamide group. If it is CH3, then it is an acetamide. Here we have a cyanoacetamide. So one of the protons from here is being substituted. One of the hydrogens is substituted by cyanide or nitrile group. And it is called as a cyanoacetamide. The cyanoacetamide reacts with ethoxyacetate in presence of mild base like piperidine. Piperidine is a mild base, while we can have strong bases such as sodium methoxide. These are stronger bases, but what will happen is that when we are using a stronger base, it will extract proton from here and there will be a different reaction will happen. What we want is we want to extract a proton from cyanoacetamide. When carbanion is generated from here, it will attack the carbonyls of the ethoxyacetate, and thereby there will be a condensation reaction occurring, a loss of water molecule, and a double bond between this carbon and this carbon will happen. Similarly, there will also be a loss of water molecule and formation of a carbon nitrogen double bond results into formation of a 6-membered ring. 1, 2, and 3 carbons from here, and 1, 2, and 3, 2 carbons and 1 nitrogen from cyanoacetamide. So overall we will have a 5 carbon and nitrogen in the ring. So total 6-membered ring we will form containing nitrogen. The 6-membered ring will have a carbon double bond over here, and we will have a nitrogen carbon double bond over here. Then we will have here as a CH2OC2H5. This one here we will have a cyanide group. So here a cyanide group. Then we will have here as a CO nitrogen. This carbon we will have a methyl group attached to here. This particular carbon. Then this will be CH2, so 2 hydrogens will be here, and then a CH2OC2H5. So next, so this group, this compound, we get it. This compound undergoes ketoenol tautomerism. to get re-aromatization or to undergo aromatization reaction. Now it is a non-aromatic compound, but when it forms a enol form, it will be a aromatic compound that we will get. So here we will have a double bond, and a double bond. Here we will have a CH2OC2H5, CN. Here we will have H. Here it will be CS3, and here we will have a OH. So when we compare it with pyridoxine over here, what we have is we want a CH2OH. We can have it at CH2OH by breaking the ether bond over here. We can easily have a CH2OH. Here CH2OH, that can be easily brought it from here by reduction of this nitrile group. We will get CH2NH2, and then NH2 can be replaced very easily by hydroxy group. This hydroxy group, we need to remove it, as is an extra group here. Methyl group, we have it as such. And here we want a hydroxy group. So we want to remove a hydroxy group from here and place it over here. So for that, what we will do is, first we will place a functional group over here so that we can convert that functional group into hydroxy group. So for that, we can use concentrated H2SO4 and concentrated HNO3, that is nitrating mixture, and reflux it so that we will have a nitro group attached to the position. Because there is no other position where a nitro group can be attached, so nitration occurs only at that position. Now, this can be reacted with PCl5 so that it will remove this hydroxy group and bring the chloro group here, chloride, with the loss of POCl3 and HCl. We can replace that hydroxy group, which is a bad leaving group, into a good leaving group like chloro. Now we can reduce this nitro group into amine by using platinum catalyst, reduction using platinum catalyst. Amine CH2OET. Here we will have CN and here CN. Further, we can react this with PDC in presence of ammonia so that there will be a reduction of this cyanide of nitrile group and also subsequent removal of chloro also happens. The chloride group will get removed and the cyanide will be reduced to CH2NH2. Here we have CH2OET. Here we have a NH2 and a CH3. Now what we have is two amines. We have two primary amines. We have one aromatic amine, the other aliphatic amine. So these two can undergo diazotization reaction. these two can undergo diazotization reaction, so that we will have here as an OH. Here CH2OH. Here we will have a methyl. Diazotization followed by hydrolysis will give us the desired hydroxy groups. Further, we can react with HBr so that this ether bond can be removed. Two moles of HBr will be required, one for this, and then and the second one will be breaking the ether bond. We will have a CH2Br here, again CH2Br. This can be further hydroxylated using silver oxide. We will get the desired molecule, which is vitamin B6. This is what we intended to synthesize. इसके नोट्स आपको नहीं मिलेंगे, आप यहां से लिखते जाओ. So this is one way of synthesizing vitamin B6. The second method is Harris synthesis of vitamin B6. This starts from ethyl ester of N-formyl DL-alanine. So it starts with ethyl ester of N-formyl DL-alanine. Alanine, we know that it is a CH3COOH. And here an NH. This is our alanine. If it is a DL alanine, then the chirality of this carbon doesn't matter. It may be either D or L alanine can be obtained. Now, what we want is ethyl ester of DL alanine. So, ethyl ester means here there will be a C2H5. So, ethyl ester of DL alanine, and we want a ethyl ester of N-formyl DL alanine. N-formyl means here it will be a formyl group will be attached. So NHCHO will be there. Formyl group attached to nitrogen. So it is N-formyl ethyl ester of DL alanine. This can be reacted with phosgene, COCl. In presence of base, like triethyl amine, to give us isocyanide. Here, this N-formyl group will be reacted to give us an isocyanide. This isocyanide can further, in the same reaction mixture, can be heated to undergo cyclization so that it will be forming a five-membered cyclic ring, one from this oxygen, this carbon, nitrogen and carbon undergoing reaction to give us a five-membered ring. An oxazole, because here there will be a oxygen and nitrogen, both will be part of this molecule, so it will be an oxazole. 1,3 oxazole derivative will be obtained. Here we will have a methyl group, and in this case we will have a OC2H5. So it will be 1,3 oxazole derivative. This can be directly obtained from ethyl ester of N-formyl DL-alanine in one single step by reacting it with P2O5 also. If we react it with P2O5 also, we will get 1,3 oxazole derivative, or if we can go through phosgene and triethylamine, then also we will get this. Now this acts as a diene and can undergo Diels-Alder reaction with a dienophile such as 2-butene-1,4-diol. It can undergo Diels-Alder reaction to obtain a six-membered ring, where there will be a bridging for this oxygen. The molecule will be containing a nitrogen. Ring will be containing nitrogen and an oxygen bridgehead. Here we will have a double bond. We have a CH2OH and a CH2OH coming from this butene diol. Here we will have a OC2H5, this particular group from here, and we will have a methyl group here. Now what we can do is it can undergo ring opening reaction such that this bond comes over here, this double bond moves here, and there will be a loss of ethoxide. We will have a six-membered ring containing nitrogen. Here we will have a hydroxy group. This hydroxy group, this oxygen is shifted over here on this carbon. So, hydroxy group will be retained here. We will have a double bond and a double bond here. A methyl group, CH2OH. Here we will have a CH2OH. So, if you can see, there are proper functional groups are present on this compound. But just now we want to aromatize this ring. It is non-aromatic, not a pyridine ring. It is a dihydropyridine. So we need to aromatize it, and that aromatization can be very easily carried out because it gains stability. So upon aromatization, we will get our desired compound. Vitamin B6 or pyridoxine. So in this way, in just few steps, we can just four steps we can synthesize pyridoxine using Harris synthesis. Harris synthesis has advantages over the normal synthesis that we had seen it just now. Here the number of steps are less, so yields will be better.